Half-a-day students, my name is Lieutenant Governor Josh Tenorio. As we battle this COVID-19 outbreak, I want you to know that together, Governor Liu and I are working very hard to do everything within our power to keep our island safe from COVID-19. In addition, we have been working closely with the Guam Department of Education and PBS Guam to bring you continuous educational curriculum while you stay home during this time. With that said, Governor Liang Guerrero and I want you to remember to stay safe. This means listening to your parents. Wash your hands for at least 20 seconds and wash your hands frequently. Together, we will get through this. To our parents, the governor and I know how important it is that we stay diligent in our efforts to keep our students of Guam healthy and safe. Thank you for stepping in with your child's education during this time. I would also like to thank each and every member of the Guam DOE team, teachers and support staff, for their hard work, boundless energy, and for their commitment to our students of Guam. To our students, we hope that you enjoy PBS University while at home. Have a great lesson.
PBS University is a program by the Guam Department of Education, PBS Guam, and in conjunction with public school teachers to create lessons that students will be able to easily follow. With the aim of helping students continue their learning at home, providing both parents and students with a unique educational experience. PBS University on PBS Guam.
Half a day, my name is John Fernandez, Superintendent of the Guam Department of Education. I want to begin by thanking you all for staying home and staying safe during the current COVID-19 pandemic. Let's continue to do our part by practicing good hygiene, social distancing, and staying home. I know it's not easy, but we can do this. Remember, we are all in this together. I know you understand why we had to close schools down for the rest of the school year, and I want you to know that your safety, the safety of your families, and the safety of employees come first. But let's not give up on teaching and learning. As you know, we have already provided a set of distance learning resources that are now on our website at www.gdoe.net. Now we're taking it to the next level with the help of Guam Public Broadcasting Service, better known as PBS. We will be launching PBS University, which will contain televised weekly lessons developed by our teachers and staff for students from K-12. These will be simple but effective lessons for students to work on at home, and they will include lessons in reading, math, and character development. These lessons will be updated weekly for the remainder of the school year and into the summer. Students, here's your opportunity to keep your mind sharp while you're stuck at home over the next few weeks. And parents, I hope that this will assist you in providing your children with dedicated instructional time and support. I want to close by just thanking those people on the front lines of the COVID-19 fight, our healthcare professionals, including our very own DOE school nurses and social workers, our law enforcement professionals, including our very own DOE student attendance officers and school resource officers, our principals and school staff, who along with Sodexo employees serve 24,000 school meals to feed our island's children, our food and nutrition employees, who are delivering food supplies to our nonprofit and government partners to assist needy families, and our teachers and staff, who have worked hard to make distance learning a reality. Finally, a message to students. Keep a positive attitude. Keep learning. We miss you, and we'll see you soon in the new school year. Si Dios maasi, and stay safe.
Oh, hi, boys and girls. This is Miss Jenny Ann Flores, first and second grade character education teacher to children all over the world, coming to you from PBS University. You might be wondering, why, what am I doing? Look at this case inside the book. Why do I have a flag? Why do I have Baymax? And why do I have a piece of luggage? Well, today I'm going to read to you a story titled, This Is Me, written by a national best-selling team, Jamie Lee Curtis and Laura Cornell. It's about a girl. Just wait and listen to the story.
This Is Me, a story of who we are and where we came from, by Jamie Lee Curtis and Laura Cornell.
My great-grandmother came from a far distant place. She came on a boat with just this small case. great-grandmother left her family and friends to cross the great sea to a land at the end. Her parents informed her she had no say. Tomorrow we leave for a place far away. So fill up this case with the things you love best. Sadly, you'll have to leave all the rest. Did she wear all her clothes to leave her more space? Could her family album fit in this case? I know she took ribbons and some things to eat and shoes when they said to take care of her feet. Her whole family tree, pen and pencil set, one writing journal, a comb and a barrette. Great-great-grandma's necklace, her own handmade doll that she clutched on her journey when she felt very small. How did she do it? What would you take? Would you be scared that you'd make a mistake? How would you know in this case what you packed that once you had left, there'd be no coming back? So you, my dear class, have big choices to make. When you bring this case home, what will you take? I take lots of photos and the doll my gram sewed and my first in line ticket to Katie's first show. Abuela's beret, my ukulele, my St. Christopher medal to look out for me. Great work, Elena. For the time that you took, this suitcase is like your own history book. For you all are, isn't just what you've got, but part what you learn, part what you're taught. Who you become starts with your past, family histories, and stories that last. Now, you take this case and imagine it's true that you're leaving and needing to choose what says you. What would you take? Which things would they be that say to the world, "Hi there, this is me"?
Off a day, lost in the Orientaria, and if I was on a journey, these are the items I would take. You know, you never know when you're gonna get stranded, so I never want to leave home without that, you know, that nice can of Spam and that corned beef, you know what I'm saying? I'm a Catholic, love Jesus. And then I always try to speak Chamorro whenever I can, and I always try to learn new words outside of the dictionary. And besides that, another part of my identity is that I always like to bring around my volleyball gear. I love playing volleyball, it's my favorite sport. And I love to keep active, so you always have a pair of running shoes or basketball shoes on me. And while I'm doing that stuff, I love listening to music. I always jam out whenever I can. And last but not least, always gotta come in with a nice shirt. Nice. I'm an island boy. I always wear island print on Sundays at church. So, those are things I would say to me. Let's go.
Hello, my name is Tina William, and these are my children.
I'm gonna bring my crown, I'm gonna bring my hair drawn, I'm gonna bring my mom's necklace, and I'm gonna bring my soldiers.
I'm gonna bring this Bible that my mom and dad reads every day, and it's in the language Chinese. And this is our fan that's weaved, and it says Chip on it, because that is where we're from. These are leaves that I made in art club, and in art club, that's the first time I learned how to draw. And this is a scrunchie that my best friend made.
Hi, these are the things I will put in my case. This is one of my favorite Filipino snacks. My parents are from the Philippines and LA. This is my favorite shirt. It reminds me of my tita who made this shirt. This is my favorite book. It reminds me of nature. This is my family picture. I love my mom and my dad and my sisters.
What I would bring if I were going off island, the absolute essentials. First, my cell phone. It's my communications, it's my camera, it's my source of information. Passport, you can't go anywhere without that. Clothing and toiletries, especially I would like to have a swimsuit so I can swim wherever I go, indoors or out, summer or winter. When I get where I'm going, I would like to be able to cook for my family and friends, some of my German and Scandinavian recipes from my family, or some Guamanian recipes that people might like to try for possibly the first time. COVID-19 stuff definitely right now wouldn't be safe to go. My address book, credit cards. So yeah, this is the most important stuff. And hopefully I could also take my grandson Edward with me because that would be such a great time for all of us. Anyway, have a great day.
So, what am I bringing in my case? I'm going to bring the Bible, the Word of God, very precious to me. I especially enjoy reading the version called The Message. I'm going to bring this flag. It says here, presented to John Frank Flores on behalf of the President of the United States and a grateful nation. This reminds me of somebody very special to me and also reminds me of Baymax. That's why I have a Baymax doll. I'm going to bring my towel. Yes, this is a towel. My cap and my goggles because I'm a swimmer. I like to swim laps, although that diving pool is closed right now. I am going to bring pictures of my family and a picture of my very special niece, Aria, to help me. And I'm going to bring some cooking mix, adobo, ginisa, sinigang. Filipino cooking is the best. As you know, I'm an avid cook and this will help me in my cooking. I bring this Dallas cowboy cap. Reminds me of my family in Dallas and cowboys. I'm going to bring this hard hat, which reminds me of two very special Russian friends. Lastly, I'm going to bring this tiffin box. Tiffin box is a metal lunch case used by children in Taiwan where I taught for a while. Very special time in my life. I hope you enjoyed that segment. Boys and girls, we all come from different places. Even though if you were born in this island, your parents, your grandparents, your great-grandparents may have come from another place. And we bring in the culture of those places where we live in now. And our communities are richer. They are enriched by what we bring into our communities. Isn't that something wonderful to celebrate? Yay! Okay, this is Miss Jenny Ann Flores, first and second grade character ed teacher to children all over the world, coming to you from PBS University. Bye!
Come along, let's sing along, we'll have a great adventure. Today's the day, let's learn to play, we'll have a great adventure. It's pretty cool and just like the awesome adventure. So grab a pen, have fun with us, the awesome adventure. The awesome adventure. Just an ever ready.
Yeah! Half a day, everyone. Welcome to first and second grade science. My name is Mr. Navaretti, and these are my nieces, Chasey and Lana.
Hi.
In today's lesson, we will be learning about weather. But first, let's read our I Can statement together. Get ready.
I can describe the patterns of weather.
We have been experiencing weather our entire lives. When we are playing in the grass, chasing leaves in the wind, jumping in rain puddles, or swimming at the beach. Exploring the different patterns of weather and building on our prior experiences will help us understand the different kinds of weather phenomena we experience every day. So, what is weather?
Weather is the state of the air or atmosphere. At a particular time and place, weather is an important part of our lives on Earth. People often look outside to see what the weather is, like before they begin their day. Observing weather can give us clues that help us dress for the day, plan activities, or prepare for a storm.
These are the different kinds of weather we experience in the world.
Rainy, stormy, cloudy, sunny, snowy, dry, blizzard, humid, windy, foggy, thunderstorm, typhoon or hurricane, tornado, hot, cold. Pop quiz! Name five types of weather. Ready, set, go! Great job, boys and girls!
The four factors that describe weather: temperature, wind, precipitation, and the state of the sky, sunlight, and clouds. Let's talk about each factor. Temperature. Temperature is a measure of how hot or cold something is. You can measure temperature using a thermometer in either Celsius or Fahrenheit. Wind. Wind is the movement of air. It can be a gentle or strong breeze. The most powerful wind happens during storms called tornadoes, cyclones, and typhoons, and most hurricanes. Changes in the temperature of air, land, and water cause wind.
Precipitation. Precipitation is the liquid and solid water particles that fall from clouds and reach the ground. These particles include drizzle, rain, snow, and hail. Precipitation occurs when warm water pushes air vapor high into the atmosphere. When it cools, the vapor condenses into water droplets that can stay liquid or freeze if enough condensation collects to saturate the air. It will fall back to Earth as precipitation.
The fourth factor that describes weather is the state of the sky. So the sunlight and the clouds. By observing the position of the sun, how the clouds are formed and where they are, can tell you much about the weather. Here are some examples of some clouds.
So what are the four factors that describe weather? Very good. Temperature, wind, precipitation, and the state of the sky, or sunlight and clouds.
All right, boys and girls, for today's activity, we will be doing a science experiment called the cloud in a bottle. But first, we need our magic spatula. Ready? Say the magic words. Abracadabra, simsalabim, bam.
Wow.
Magic! The power of the magic spatula! So the materials you'll be needing are 1 2-liter bottle, 1 foot pump, rubbing alcohol, and you'll also need a valve stem, where you can get it from any auto parts store. Step number one, attach your valve stem to your foot pump, like this. Ta-da! Step number two, you're going to get your 2-liter bottle, and then you're gonna get your rubbing alcohol. Pour just a little bit of rubbing alcohol into your 2-liter bottle. Now you don't wanna add too much, just a little. Maybe just a little bit more. That's good. That's good. Okay. All right.
Let's go in.
Step number three. Get your 2-liter bottle and shake that alcohol all over on the inside of your bottle. Very nice. This will add moisture into the bottle. Step number four. Now, get your 2-liter bottle, get your pump, and go ahead and put the valve stem tightly sealed on your 2-liter bottle. Now what we're going to do is change the state of matter of the liquid, the condensation, and evaporate it into a gas form. Step number five, create pressure by pumping the foot pump.
By putting pressure into the bottle, you create energy that generates heat, which then evaporates the liquid inside the bottle.
Now you can feel the bottle expanding, that means we put a lot of pressure into the liquid inside here. Now once we release this pressure, the condensation inside the bottle will turn into a
gas.
Gas. 3, 2, 1.
Can I feel it?
Now check it out, we created a
Can we touch it?
Cloud. You can take a look at
Is
it.
Is that a cloud?
Yep. It's a cloud.
It's so hot.
Isn't that cool? All right, so here is the cloud inside the bottle.
Yeah.
Okay.
Wait, try
now the molecules inside the bottle have expanded. But watch when we add pressure again.
Clouds are created when water vapor and invisible gas turns into liquid water droplets. These water droplets form on tiny particles like dust that are floating in the air. The process of water changing from a gas to a liquid is called condensation. And when gas changes directly into a solid, it is called deposition. These two processes are how clouds are formed.
Casey, you
want to
release it?
Release!
3, 2, 1.
I don't know how to do it.
Pull it up.
Whoa!
Not the
wall!
Cloud in a bottle. All right, boys and girls, so that concludes the science lesson for today. I hope you had a lot of fun learning about the weather and knowing how to create a cloud inside a bottle. It's a fun activity that you can do at home. It's safe and easy to do. And remember, make sure you ask your mommies and daddies for help. Have a great and wonderful day. Please be safe, take care, and stay awesome. Bye, guys.
Hi kids, welcome back to PBS University. This is Miss Paris again, and I want to talk about, have you ever had to share something with your sister or your brother? Say, like a cookie. There's only one cookie, but you have to split it between the two of you. Can you share a cookie? Yes, you can. What about an apple, just one apple? Can you share an apple between the two of you? Yes, you can. How can you if you only have one thing and there's two of you? How can you share something? You cut it in half, yes. And when you cut it in half, it becomes two pieces, two equal pieces. So today we're going to learn about fractions. Have you heard of half? What is half? How do you write half? Today we will learn how to write half with using numbers and symbol. To help us learn about fractions, we're going to read a book. Come join me and let's read a book. Give Me Half by Stuart J. Murphy, illustrated by G. Brian Karras. I have one whole pizza and it's all for me. I'm going to get some pizza, just you wait and see. I know you want some pizza, sis. You only get one slice. You'd better give me more than that. Why can't you be nice? You have to share the pizza. It must be split in two. The pieces should be cut the same for each of you. One half pizza and one half pizza make one whole pizza. One half and one half is one. One half plus one half equals one. What is that behind her back? The last can of juice, I think. If he takes some juice from me, I won't have much to drink. I gave you half of mine, so you must share yours too. I'll give you just a sip, but not until I'm through. Split the juice in half. Again, you have to share. And when you pour it out, make sure that you pour fair. One half can of juice and one half can of juice make one whole can of juice. Half and half is one. Half plus half equals one. I know she has some cupcakes. I saw her with a pack. I'm going to hide my cupcakes and save them for a snack. Hey, what's that on your chair? You'd better give me some. I'm going to eat them both myself and leave you just a crumb. Your cupcakes must be shared, and do I need to repeat? You both get half the pack, and don't you too dare cheat. One cupcake and one cupcake make a pack of two cupcakes. One and one is two. One plus one equals two. One is half of two. I have a stack of cookies, but you just get one bite. You'd better give me half that stack or else I'll start a fight. Hey, wait, too late. There are cookies on the floor. There's pizza everywhere. There's juice spilled on the table and sticky stuff under my chair. We're going to be in trouble. We've made a great big mess. But I have no more than you, and you have made no less. We'd better each clean half. There's so much work to do. We'll be done in half the time if Buddy helps us too. That was a good book. I hope you learned a little bit more about fractions. Here to help us again is my friend, and she has a pizza to help us learn about fractions. Let's say hi to my friend.
Hey guys, I'm back. And today we're going to be learning fractions. This is a whole pizza. This pizza isn't cut yet, so that means it's a whole pizza. One whole pizza. Now we're going to cut it in half. Now it's in two pieces. So they are half pieces, one half and one half.
Fractions are part of a whole. The top is the numerator. This tells how many of the whole number. The whole number is the denominator, which is the number on the bottom. Let's look at the pizza again. How many pieces are there? Yes, two. So the whole amount of pieces will be the denominator. Where does that go? Yes, on the bottom. Now, if you get one piece, you will have one half of the pizza.
Cut it again into four pieces. Now there are quarter pieces. So now they're in four quarters. One quarter, two quarter, three quarter, four quarter.
Let's look at the pizza again. Now, how many pieces are there? Yes, four. So what will the whole number be? Yes, four. And where does four go? On the bottom. And what's that name again? It's the denominator. Yes. So the four goes on the bottom, and now you get a piece of the pizza. How much of the pizza do you have? Yes, a quarter of the pizza or 1/4? Say 1/4 or 1/4. Great work, everyone.
I hope you learned fractions today. I had fun with you guys and see you next time. Bye.
Okay, we're going to do a few questions to see if you understand more about fractions. Let's take a look. Okay, let's review fractions. What is the number on top called? Yes, the numerator. That tells how many parts of the whole you have. What is the number on the bottom called? Yes, the denominator. It gives you the whole number of pieces there are. Now let's see if you could do fractions. Let's look at the pizza again. Okay, let's say you get this many pieces of the pizza. How much of the pizza do you have? Yes, you have 3/4 of the pizza. How about this pizza? Let's say you have this much of the pizza. How much of the pizza do you have? Yes, 5/8 of the pizza. Now this pizza, let's say you have this much of the pizza. How much do you have? Yes, 2/4, or you could even say you have half of the pizza. Great job with this quick review of fractions. Well, that's it for today, friends. I hope you had fun today learning with me, learning about fractions, and with my friend, and with the pizza. Until next time, please stay safe, wash your hands, and please think, what can you do to help somebody? Maybe you could share your cookie with them. Till next time, take care. See you later. Bye.
You start with water, with warm or cold. Make sure the water's running when you turn it on. Be sure to lather when you're at home. And when you buy essentials outside of your zone, you have to get the back of your hands and between your fingers too. Don't think too hard about it, just have fun. Ooh, get every nook and cranny beneath your fingernails too. Just rinse them down and dry them up and you're done. When you wash your hands, make sure the germs go. Sing happy birthday twice so you know. Count to 20 or play this video and sing it with me.
Sing it with me.
When you cough or when you sneeze and you wash your hands. Before you eat and after eating you wash your hands. Come on. All those things you touch outside you should wash your hands. Do your house a favor and keep washing.
Don't point your fingers.
You should wash your hands. When you wash your hands, make sure the germs go. Sing happy birthday twice so you know. Count to 20 or play this video and sing it with me.
Sing it with me.
Sing with me. When you cough or when you sneeze and you wash your hands. Before you eat and after eating you wash your hands. Come on. All those things you touch outside, you should wash your hands. Do your house a favor and keep washing.
Got to get between my fingers. Got to get underneath my nails. Come on. Got to get between my fingers. Got to get underneath my nails. Come on. Got to get between my fingers. Got to get underneath my nails. Come on.
Hi,
Hi, my name is Leo, reporting from my home for Nanny News. Today, I will be showing you what I do to stay happy and healthy. And I am practicing a ukulele, and these are the chords I use.
I also like to practice jumping rope every day.
Love to do bubbles.
I also like to cook.
Again, this is Zio reporting for Nanny News. Thank you for watching. Sayonara.
If you would like to be featured on Nanny News, to share what you are doing at home to stay healthy, happy, and safe, you can go to our website, manyelu.org, and click on Nanny News. There, you will find all the steps your parents or guardians need to take for you to be featured. We are excited to hear from you.
COVID-19 can't stop us from training.
Happy day, boys and girls, and welcome back to PBS University Guam. It's Mrs. Stella here, your reading teacher for today for first and second grade. I'm so excited about today's lesson because I love, love, love reading stories. And today I'm going to share with you one of my favorite stories. It's called A Soup Opera. Have you read this story? But before we go into this story, I want to review our lesson for today, which is finding the moral of a story, or what lessons can be learned after reading a story. There's a lot of different stories out there and a lot of popular stories. And within a story, there's morals. There's lessons to be learned after reading them. So today, we're going to look at some really quick examples of stories and what moral of the story we can learn from them. And then we're going to read one of my favorite stories. And we're going to see what lesson can be learned from that story. And also, boys and girls, today, if you have with you a notebook or a sheet of paper, please make sure you have that and something to write with. I have here my pencils, a wooden and a mechanical one. So just have a sheet of paper and something to write with, because we're going to take some notes. We're going to draw a web to brainstorm ideas of what could the moral of a story be after we've read a story. So here we go. Let's try this out. In our lesson today, let's take a look at our learning goal. Repeat after me. I can determine the moral of a story. Great job. So cool. So I just want to show you this book before you read it. So here's the title of the story, A Soup Opera. And the cool thing with this story was it was actually a gift given to me by Professor Miss Claire. And this was also, it comes with a read-along CD. You're going to hear the sound effects. It's so much fun. And then in the back, it shows all the different voices for the characters. And it's really, really fun because it has something to do with singing. And Stella loves to sing. So please enjoy while we read A Soup Opera.
This is a drama about a man and a bowl of soup. A drama that is set to music is an opera. So this is... A Soup Opera. A man walked into one of the finest restaurants in the city and was seated at the very best table.
Hello.
Soon, a waiter appeared with a menu. I don't need a menu, the man said. Just tell me, what kind of soup are you serving today? The waiter smiled and said, The chef's specialty, sir, onion soup. Onion soup sounds delicious, said the man. I'll take a bowl. The waiter promptly returned with a big bowl of the onion soup. He set the bowl down in front of the man. He turned, began to walk away, but was stopped. Excuse me, said the man. The waiter lifted his arms and sang,
What seems to be the problem here?
The man replied,
I can't eat the soup. What did you say? I can't eat the soup.
The waiter scratched his head, thought for a moment, and said, I'll have to get the chef. The chef hurried in with a ladle and sang,
What seems to be the problem here?
I can't eat the soup.
Slapped the ladle in her palm, thought for a moment, and said, I'll have to get a policeman. A policeman strolled in, wearing a big badge. He sang,
What seems to be the problem here? I can't eat the soup. What did you say? I can't eat the
The policeman stroked his chin, thought for a moment, and said, I'll have to get the mayor. The mayor stomped in and waved his big pen in the air as he sang,
What seems to be the problem here? I can't eat the soup. What did you say? I can't eat the soup.
The mayor thought for a moment, pointed a finger in the air, and said, I'll have to get the president. And then the President of the United States walked into the restaurant. The president sang,
What seems to be the problem here?
I can't eat the soup.
What did you say?
I can't eat the soup.
The president stopped singing and simply asked, "Why can't you eat the soup, sir?"
"Because I have no spoon."
All right, boys and girls, let's take out your sheet of paper and a pen or pencil, and I want you to draw a circle right in the middle of your paper. Now I want us to add three branches to the circle, two at the top and one branch at the bottom. Now we finished reading the soup opera, so write the title right in the middle of our circle, a soup opera. Now the branches are going to be for us to brainstorm ideas of lessons or moral of the story. Here are some examples. When you feel frustrated, ask for help. If you need help, ask questions. And a funny one, always have a spare spoon. If you have any other ideas, write another branch at the bottom and put your ideas down.
That's it for today's lesson, boys and girls. I really hope you enjoyed reading along with the soup opera and remembering that a moral means the lesson of a story, or what did we learn after reading the story. Don't forget, it's always important to take notes when you read a story to help you remember what the story was about and also remember the things that a story has taught you. So, before I go, don't forget, please make sure to stay home and stay safe and continue to make good choices. I'll see you when I see you.
Bye.
Hi guys, this is Miss Nicholas. I have here probably a familiar face already, my cousin Austin. Austin, go ahead and say hi to them.
Hi.
Austin, I brought you here today because I have a simple question for you. Are you ready for your question?
Yes.
Okay, Austin. If you had the choice to choose between this bag of markers or this bag of markers, which one would you choose to color with?
This.
This one. Why would you choose this bag?
Because it has different colors.
You can go ahead and hold on to that one. Why not this one?
Because it's just the same color, yellow.
Okay, Austin, thank you so much for joining us. I'm going to call our other special guest today, Victoria. Hi, Victoria.
Hi.
Okay, Victoria, I have the same question I had for your brother. If you had the choice to color using this bag with all different colored markers or this bag which only has yellow markers, which one would you rather color with?
This.
Okay, you can go and hold on to that one. Why do you want to color with that bag?
Because it's both different colors and that one's the same color.
Same color? Okay. Okay, my friends at home, now it's your turn to choose. If you had the choice to choose between this bag of yellow markers or this bag with a variety of different colored markers, which one would you rather choose to color with? If you're anything like my cousins, I'm going to bet that you probably chose the variety bag of colors. Why would you choose the variety bag of colors? Absolutely, because when you're drawing or coloring, it's usually a lot more fun if you have a lot of different colors to choose from. In today's lesson, we are going to be talking about diversity. What is diversity? It's simple. Diversity means differences. Just like my bag of markers, people around the world come in different colors, shapes, and sizes. We are all beautifully different, and we should celebrate those differences. If the world was like this bag of markers, where we were all exactly the same, it would be... right! The world would be so boring! Besides what we look like, because we all look differently, I look different than you, you might look different than your mom or dad. No two people in this world are exactly the same. Well, maybe identical twins. But anyway, there are so many different ways that we are unique. Some example of our unique characteristics could be our religion, our age, who we love, what our families look like, where we come from, the color of our skin, or even people who might act a little bit different or behave differently. Today I want to read to you guys another one of my favorite books called All Are Welcome by Alexandra Penfold and Suzanne Kaufman.
All Are Welcome, written by Alexandra Penfold and Suzanne Kaufman. Pencils sharpened in their case. Bells are ringing, let's make haste. School's beginning, dreams to chase. All are welcome here. No matter how you start your day, what you wear when you play, or if you come from far away, all are welcome here. In our classroom, safe and sound, fears are lost and hope is found. Raise your hand, we'll go around. All are welcome here. Gather now, let's all take part. We'll play music, we'll make art. We'll share stories from the heart. All are welcome here. Time for lunch. What a spread! A dozen different kinds of bread. Pass it around till everyone's fed. All are welcome here. Open doors. Rush outside. We will swing. We will slide. We'll have fun side by side. All are welcome here. We're part of a community. Our strength is our diversity. A shelter from adversity. All are welcome here. We will learn from each other. Special talents we'll uncover. There's a big world to discover. All are welcome here. So much to learn, so much to do. And when the busy day is through, can't wait to come back, start anew. All are welcome here. Head for home to get some rest and greet tomorrow, ready and fresh. Our time together is the best. All are welcome here. You have a place here. You have a space here. You are welcome here.
Wow, I really appreciate that book. I know as a teacher in my classroom, I want every single person, no matter what they look like, what they're able to do, or where they come from, I want them to feel comfortable and loved by myself and by their other classmates. Let's take a look at how students with disabilities or different needs work together with their peers to create an awesome sports team.
I'm Rob Mitchell, I'm the Senior Director of Program for Special Olympics New York. One of the programs I oversee is Unified Sports, so creating inclusive sports programs for children and adults with and without disabilities. Okay, we're here today at Cuca College for our Unified Basketball event. We've got Penyan Elementary School here, Dundee Elementary School here, and I'm sure you can hear them outside. Everybody's having a fantastic time getting ready to play some basketball. What this program does is it says we're all the same. You know, we have far more in common than we are different. And can we find a way to all interact together so that we don't have certain students that are on the outside?
Well, I've made a couple of friends, like two or three. And I like it here because I can finally be me. Usually I get picked on at school for having ADHD and stuff like that.
All too often that bullying is due to a lack of understanding. They don't, the students who are bullying, they don't know the students they are bullying. They just see them as being different and an easy target. Whereas in the setting like this, it's more intimate, if you will. They get to know them and they realize this is just a really good person. And so in that environment where they actually get to know the person, that bullying doesn't exist because they are all just good people.
Today, it's all about everybody having fun and working together and cheering you on no matter how well you do. It's more about how hard you try and how much fun you have. So today they kind of met for the first time and it's been cool to see the friendships kind of evolve and they've gotten to know each other's names and they're calling each other's names on the court. And like I said, a lot of these kids didn't know each other very well until today and now they're part of a team.
We're bringing people from all different segments of this community parents whose children have unique challenges, and we're all coming together and we're creating this opportunity for everyone. I think it's quite unifying, as the title would suggest.
Okay guys, something that I noticed in that video was that people who hadn't really talked to each other before were all of a sudden realizing that they had a lot more in common with their peers than they thought. One of the easiest ways to make new friends is to be willing to talk to other people and being open to people's differences. You could ask them a few questions. I'm going to be asking a few of my lovely, diverse students that I've had before a few questions.
Nipo, my name is Enter.
Mabuhay, kamusta?
Half a day, guahum siliya suling kinata.
Chicken and rice and eggs.
I don't.
Pancit, red rice and spinach.
We go somewhere and we buy our clothes and we have fun.
Christmas, because we all get to go together and it's the most important tradition.
My birthdays, because we get to get together.
I like to do TikTok.
I like to sing, I like to surf and ride bicycles.
I like to do art.
Pineapples, watermelon, mermaids, like all kinds of stuff.
Great listening, guys. All of you at home should be extremely proud of your culture and all of the characteristics that make you unique. Remember, our community is diverse for a reason. If we were not diverse or different and we all looked the same, we would be a boring bag of yellow markers. But because we are all so different and diverse, we are this bag of markers and the world is a beautiful, colorful place. Okay guys, thank you so much for joining me today. I'll see you next time. Bye.